Using a very simple example, we will discuss what is mean, median, mode, and percentile. We will also see how these concepts are used in the field of data science and machine learning, and then we'll write Python code to practice some of these concepts. And most important, in the end, we have an exercise for you to practice upon. So let's begin. Let's say you want to open a luxurious car showroom in Monroe Township, New Jersey. Before opening the store, you will go through some data analysis process. For example, you will examine the income level of people in that area. Because if the income levels are high, then people will buy BMWs. If the income level are, if people are living on a government aid, they're not probably going to buy a BMW, so it doesn't make sense to open a showroom. So you will get the statistics or the data on the people's income. And one measure you can use is the average income to figure out if you want to open the store. Here, in this case, my average income for all these people is $6,250 per month, which is not that high. So I'll probably not open that luxurious car showroom. But I got lucky here. What if this data set has some outlier? Outlier means some unusual values. Let's say Mr. Elon Musk is living in my town. He obviously has a very high income. And if I use average now, the average will be 1.43 million. And if I use this average number to make that decision, then it will be a bad decision. Because obviously, people are not earning 1.43 million on average. We got this number just because of some outliers. So in this case, using average is not a good idea. So then what we should do here? Well, let's do this. Let's sort the values in ascending order. And here are my values. What if instead of using average, I use the middle value? So see, in the data set, my middle value is this, 7,000. So instead of average, I'm using middle value to make that decision. And this middle value is nothing but a median. What if my data set has even number of data points? See, here I have total seven. So this was an easy thing. It was a middle number, but I have 7 data points. What is my middle number? It is this or that. Well, the problem is easy to solve. You draw a line here. You take both the numbers and take an average. So in this case, the median is 7,500. So overall, if your number of data points are even, then you take 2 middle values, take the average, that's your median. If your data points are odd, then you take the middle value and that's your median. So this is the first use case of using median in a simple descriptive statistics. The other use case is handling missing values. Let's say you are building a machine learning model which can predict if person's loan should be approved or not. Here my features are credit score and monthly income. And some of my data points have missing values. For example, I don't know what is Sophia's monthly income. In this case, in our data science, we try to estimate the monthly income. So here, again, you can use average maybe to estimate her monthly income. What will be the average, by the way? 1.6 million, wow. So I took all these values, but because I have Mr. Musk living in my town, he's my neighbor, and because he has $10 million income, it is skewing up our average number. So to approximate this, Sophia might be earning $1.6 million a month is not a good idea. Here again, we can use median. So you take middle two values, average it out, 6,500, and that's probably a better approximation. Okay, so although 10 million is present here, median allowed me to come up with a right guess. So overall, in the field of data science, so far we looked at two cases. One was a descriptive analysis for opening car showroom. The second one was a loan approval model for data cleaning process. There are many other use cases, but I think these two use cases will give you a solid understanding of how median is used in a real life. Now let's look at the same income example once again. And here, obviously, 10 million is an outlier. And the definition of outlier is basically a data point that is very different from the rest of the data points. So now let's look at how can you remove this outlier. In order to understand that, we need to understand the concept of a percentile. So here again, I have sorted the values in ascending order. You take the middle value, okay? And that middle value, what it shows is 50% of the data points are on the left side, 50% of the data point are on the right hand side, okay? So this is your median basically. And this median is nothing but a 50th percentile. 50th percentile means, okay, what does it mean? 15th percentile here is 7,000. And it means that 50% of my data points have value less than 7,000. I have total 7 data points. And the 3 data points are around 50%, right? So so 50% of data points have value less than 7,000. Hence, 7,000 is my 50th percentile. Okay, now think about it. What is my 100th percentile? You need to think this way. Pause the video and think. Which is the value for which 100% of data points are less than or equal to that value? Well, obviously that value is 10 million. 100% of data points are less than or equal to that value, which is 10 million. So in this case, 100th percentile is 10 million. What is 0th percentile? Obviously 4,000. Okay, what is 25th percentile? Again, I want you to pause this video right now. Think about it. I'm pretty sure you will be able to come up with the right answer. All right. So total values are 7. 25% of 7 values are 1.75, which is approximately 2, which means I want you to draw a line after 2 data points. Okay, 1 and 2. Let's draw a line. Here's the line. Okay. So this line, this particular point is my 25th percentile. This point is 5500. That is my 25th percentile. Now, just to clarify, there are different ways of calculating percentile. I just showed you one, but another approach is to take this 5000 data point. Third approach is 6000. You know, so percentile could be 5500, 5000 or 600. Basically, either 5000, which is a lower value, 6000, which is a higher value, or a value in between. And I will show you a page which will exactly tell you the formula for this. Okay, what is 75th percentile? Again, pause the video and think. You should be able to come up with the answer. Total value is 7. 75% of 7 is 5. So draw a line after 5 data points. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here is my line. Okay, what is this data point? 7750. So that's my 75th percentile. If you have 25th percentile and 75th percentile, then the range, you know, the range is called interquartile range. You will hear this term a lot if you are studying data science. And it's a very simple concept. It's a range between 25th and 75th percentile. If the range is between min and max, then it's called a range in general, you know. So general range and IQR are kind of same, but IQR is between 25th and 75th percentile. If you want to know more about IQR, I have a video where I showed you how you can use IQR to remove outliers. The link is in the description below. Please check it out. All right, back to our example of outlier removal. So how do you remove this outlier? Well, one approach is, what if I say I want to remove all the values which are more than 99th percentile. So here 99th percentile will be 10 million, and we'll write the code for this same thing so you'll understand why. And easily we can remove that 10 million outlier using percentile. Okay, so just to summarize, we looked at two use cases of percentile here. One is income data set outlier removal. The other use case is very common, by the way. If you have given SAT or GRE exam, many exams nowadays have percentile score or a relative score rather than percentage or absolute score, which means if you get, let's say, 75% in the examination, but no one else got more marks than you, let's say you got the highest mark, then although absolute percent is 75%, your percentile will be 100, because it's a maximum. So percentile is relative scoring and it's used a lot in the exam scores. Okay, now if you're curious about how exactly percentile is calculated, here is the page. This is a very good website, statisticshowto.com. I will put a link of this below. You can read the math, but even if you don't want to go detail into math, it's fine as long as you understand the concept. Now, what the heck is mode? Well, mode is very simple. You guys are using that in everyday life. Let's say you are working in a team and team wants to go for a team lunch. Your manager will tell you, okay, I want to conduct a restaurant survey. So the people in the team will fill out the survey. You know, Rob and Rafik will say, I want to eat Mexican, Nina, Italian, and so on. What will your manager do? Well, simple. He will take the maximum, right? So the maximum is called mode. So maximum votes are Mexican, and that maximum votes is nothing but a mode. So mode is the most frequently occurring value in a data set. We use mode for so many things in real life. We just don't know this fancy term called mode. So I thought I will just give you a quick idea. Let's write Python code now. I have the income data in CSV file and I have loaded that into a pandas data frame here. You can see there are 7 rows in total. And what we're going to do is use percentile to remove the outlier that we have here. And first function I will call is derived of describe. This will give you basic statistics of a data frame, such as count, mean, standard deviation, and so on. But look at these three important numbers. This is showing you the 25th percentile, which was 5500. So if you remember from our presentation, our 25th percentile was 5500. Our 75th percentile was 7750. See, 7750. So the describe function gives all those awesome statistics. You can also call df.income, which will give you, of course, this column, which is a pandas series, and quantile function. So quantile. Okay. Quantile, if you do 0.75, it will give you the same number, 7750. Give 25, gives you this number. You can give any number, by the way. You can give 45, for example, 45th quantile. And it will just work as okay. If you do Google search on this API, remember in the presentation I told you that there are different ways of calculating quantile. For example, let's look at 25th quantile. Okay, 550. But if you look at the documentation, if you do shift tab, you see this parameter interpolation is linear. So there are a couple of values that it can take. It can take values such as lower, higher, nearest, midpoint. So let's try lower and higher. So here, if I do interpolation is equal to lower. So when you do lower, let me show you what it will do. So when you do lower, it will actually give you this 5000 points. See? So if I do lower, it gives you 5000. If I do higher, it will give you 6000. So 5000 and 6000, our values in between. But if you do interpolation linear, it will just take, use those two numbers. Okay. Now, if you do zeroth quantile, 4000. If you do one quantile, the maximum number, Mr. Elon Musk, it will give you that. All right. Now, we want to use quantile to remove the outlier. So how about we use, let's say, for example, 0.99. I want to discard anything that is more than 99th quantile. So 99th quantile is 9.4 million. Okay. So let's store this in a variable. So percentile 99. And then I will say, okay, in my data frame, give me all data points who are greater than this percentile. And it gives me Elon Musk. This is an outlier. And if you want to remove it and prepare a new data frame, which you call it df no outlier, okay, then see this df no outlier. So you have to reverse these conditions. You have to say, my valid values are anything which is less than 99th percentile. And I just remove the outlier, my data frame is ready. This is what data scientists do. They do a lot of data cleaning, data preparation, and outlier removal is a very important step in that process. Now let's look at the second use case, which is filling a missing values. So again, I have this data frame, and in that, let me make Sophia's income null so that I can show you how NA can be filled using a median. So I will do something like, okay, 3, that will give me this, and at 3, row number 3, my income, I want to make it np.nan. Actually, I need to do iLocation. iLocation will give you that location. All right. So this worked. And if I do df now. All right. Something is not right. All right. Looks like there is some problem. I'll do it reverse way. I'll take the column df income. And then at number 3, I will store NAN. And now you see Sophia's income is NN. Let's assume in real life when you are dealing with your data, you know, many times the data, some of the data points will not have a value because of data transmission error, because the data is not available, whatever reason. But this is what happens in data scientist life, that some of the values are missing and you need to substitute that with the right guess. So if you make your guess such that, let's say I'm saying my mean can be used as a substitute. So my mean for the income is this much, and it is very high because of this outlier. But if I use that to fill NA, there is a function called fill NA. And if I use that, let me store this in a new variable. It's gonna be a disaster because on average, all these guys have 5,000, 6,000, 4,000 values, but the Sophia's income is now 1.6 million and it became this high because of outlier. So here is a classic case where you should not use mean, you should use median instead. And we can copy paste the same function here, but instead of mean, you do median. And when you do it now, the values look more reasonable. You know, $6,500 as a substitute for value that is not available sounds far more reasonable than filling it with 1.6 million. So you can see that whenever you have outliers, the values are not in a kind of same range, you should use median instead of mean to fill the NA values. That's all I had for this tutorial. The most important part of this tutorial is an exercise. I have this exercise for you. The link for this will be found in a video description below. What you have to do is you need to use this Airbnb New York dataset, which is available on Kaggle. So download this CSV file by clicking on this button and use percentile to remove the outliers. That dataset has some outliers. You want to remove them using appropriate percentile, both on the lower and right end. And there is a solution link, but I trust you, you guys and girls are all very sincere students, and you will click on solution only once you have tried on your own. All right. Thank you very much for watching this, and I will see you in a next video.